EFF says, yes, we note the death of Pravin Gordhan, but it should be noted that Pravin Gordhan has got a babizangan. He's a man with a mixed legacy, so we're not going to moan him. That's how they just went straight to the point and said, he's involved in the destruction of our state-owned company. So why must we celebrate him? You think I'm joking? In a letter that was released by EFF on the 13th of September 2024, it reads as follows. The economic freedom fighter EFF notes the death of Pravin Gordhan without any pretense of sorrow. Gordhan was a man whose legacy is deeply intertwined with the destruction of our state-owned enterprise and the betrayal of the people of South Africa. We cannot mourn counter-progressive forces that stood against the potential of building a successful sovereign country that serves its people. Instead, we are reminded of the Yay! This is EFF. They right, and paragraph second, paragraph sitting. His rise within the ANC ranks led to his appointment to the as a Minister of Finance in 2009 under President Jacob Zuma, as a position he held until 2024. Then again from 2015 to 2017, after briefly stepping down, however, Gordhan had already been pointed out earlier on his disruptive role in the struggle for our liberation, when he was named by the ANC president Oliver Tambo as a key member of a secret Indian cabal of 1980s. Oh my God. EFF continued, the cabal was notorious for the prosecution of Mama Winnie Mandela, which was rejected by our people. Later on, Gordhan also admitted to the formation of the notorious Roji unit within South African Revenue Service, which terrorized political rivals on behalf of white monopoly capital. And which Commander-in-Chief Julius Malema was a target of. In 2018, Gordhan was appointed Minister of Public Enterprise under President Cyril Ramaphosa, a move that signaled his role in cleaning up every state-owned enterprise that would later deteriorate under his leadership. It is here in his final public role that Gordhan will preside over disintegrated of South Africa's most critical state asset. You see, on this one, I want to ask you a question. Will you blame the EFF for speaking like this about Gordhan or not? And I'll tell you why I'm asking that question. And I will make you understand why I'm basically asking you this question, right? With that being said, I want us to do the right thing, subscribe, all those necessary things. But the letter from the EFF is very long, so you'll have to bear with me because it's a bit long. And I am definitely going to do the right thing, and I'm gonna take you through all of this long letter. But before we can continue to do so, please do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy
more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, let's proceed. Quran was the embodiment of greed, corruption, and elitism. His tenure as a minister of public enterprise was a period of unparalleled disaster of every state-owned enterprise he touched. Under his leadership, Eskom became a shadow of its former self, plunging this country into a permanent state or local state of load shedding. This blackout sheltered livelihood and business across the nation. Transnet, which was once facilitated efficient movement of goods, is now in ruin, barely able to function. Danel, a proud defense company, was brought to its knees, while SAA, a national airline, was sold off in a corrupt deal that reeks of treason. Now, there is no media house that will come for EFF and say, you are insensitive. There is no one. You know why I'm saying there's no one? Because when Dudumyeni died, even at her death, they still write derogatory terms, right? Hey, the disgrace has died. Nobody, therefore, now that Gordon has died, nobody's going to come here and say, yeah, hey, you can't speak like that. You are in Africa. Where was the Africanism when Dudumyeni died? At her death, she was labeled a disgrace. Where was Ubuntu, the African? Because I heard Mbalula saying, hey, people cannot do this. It's an African. Hey. Where was the Africanism or African thing or whatever African, what that must be in people? Where was it when Dudumyeni died? When Dudumyeni died, go back to my videos. I even said that, few of them that I remember in mind, Daddy Maverick wrote the disgrace to Dudumyeni. News 24, the disgrace to Dudumyeni. All of them forgot about us being Africa. But when Gordon dies, we must now remember that we are Africans. We must speak well of Gordon. I'm saying nobody's going to come for EFF because they started this themselves. So even when their favorite dies, because they started this of not respecting other people when they are dead. Then he says, the infamous SAA Toxo deal with Gordon orchestrated remain one of the most scandalous example of how he sold our nation's asset for private interest. The deal was inexplicable, underhanded, and deliberately designed to benefit a secret few at the expense of many. Even now, the full extent of its treacherous has not been properly scrutinized because Gordon, a man at the center of corruption, evaded accountability every turn. The next paragraph says, in fact, in his final days as minister, Gordon brazenly spat at the face of South Africans, refusing to account to them. When summoned to appear before parliament, the very institution through which he was supposed to answer to the people of South Africa, he arrogantly and unapologetically declared that he will not comply, showing his utter disdain for South Africans. His unchecked power allowed him to operate with impunity, and now he dies with his crimes unpunished. Every collapsed enterprise, every failure that left hundreds of thousands unemployed as part of Pravin Gordhan's shameful legacy. As an unapologetic instrument of capitalism, he deliberately dismantled every every word entangles means to uplift and develop our nation. His actions directly contributed to the high level of unemployment, leaving countless families who are still suffering in silence. Gordhan betrayed the workers, the poor, the oppressed. He did so without shred of remorse. We will not shed a tear for the likes of Pravin Gordhan. No, we will celebrate the false legacy created by his apologist. He will be remembered for his role in sitting in the growth of our nation, destroying the hopes of millions, enabling the collapse. Oh, my daughter. Give me a moment. Enabling the collapse of state entities. His death comes before he could face justice. But those left behind will continue to suffer the consequences of his betrayal as Minister of Public Enterprise. Gordhan's legacy is one of failures, exploitation, corruption. May we never allow another Pravin Gordhan to rise again. I think I read it in the spirit of EFF, guys. I tried to read it in the spirit of EFF. Now, do let me know. Get into the comment section below. Tell me what you've got to think about what has been said here. Is it true or false? But I think it's true. You know what I'm saying? That's me, by the way. So I'm a man. Born under sin, subject to correction.